I'm curious if you can articulate what the unique power of documentary cinema is to explore both our issues and our icons.
I think what's interesting about documentaries is it is intimate, and you're kind of, you know, like, I think we're so used to things being so manufactured, like this kind of facade put up, this kind of big shield, and not knowing what's real and living in this fantasy. Actually, when you kind of see things and they're being told in a kind of, you know, a newsworthy kind of way, or, you know, reportage or archive, and, you know, you're seeing historical things or you're getting to know somebody, you really are truly getting to know somebody. And even like there's so many kind of like interesting things you can do being a documentary maker, like to get, because a lot of people come very prepared, for instance, and they don't like talking about certain things, and the whole thing about a documentary is you need to kind of reveal certain things. So I think you know, there's little, not tricks, and you don't want to trip anyone up, but you need people to be honest and to be real. And the whole thing about documentary making is it's really honest. And that's what I love, why I love doing it. And you get some of the best, biggest conversations from people.
Just finally, on the subject of your own documentary, can you talk a little bit about why, of all of the great icons of that era, Twiggy was someone who you wanted to celebrate and explore on screen, and how it's felt to have the contributions you've had thus far from amazing people like Sir Paul McCartney?
Yeah. It just happened. Like, some things in my career have just happened kind of naturally, and they've just evolved. And I knew I wanted to direct, and I got offered to do the Mary Quant one. And a lot of people responded well to that. So then when Mary Quant came out, I was doing a podcast with Twiggy, and I said, oh, if ever you want to do a film about your life, and she was like, no, never. And I said, oh, well, if you change your mind, call me up, which she did. And then it was amazing. And the reason I wanted to do Twiggy was because, well, one, I think the thing is, like, I kind of understand certain worlds. I grew up in the 60s, but I've been involved in film and fashion, you know, myself, and I've been a woman in, you know, certain parts of my life in kind of, not as much as someone like Twiggy in the spotlight. So I can kind of understand it. I can kind of identify with it. And, you know, I don't want anyone to feel uncomfortable. I want to just really shine a light on what that person is. And I think, you know, I think any subject you choose is going to be a challenge. But I want there to be a certain kind of style. I want it to be real and honest, but I want it to have a style. And I think that's what's so fun about directing documentaries about powerful, iconic women, and also women in fashion.